at school in the winter's fall. Lovebirds clocking kind of whimsical as the crimson leaves left the trees into all the streets freezing. Feelings deepened in intervals seemed indivisible. It's visible to see that these sweet individuals would wander in their glee, fondled free in the parts of the dark, dark back. Poems that are pleasing the past in a black rucksack. It's getting deep when they're on their own, spending all the time apart, speaking on the phone. Past GCSEs departed on alone, promising that after their degrees they'd be invited the home. And so they did by the seaside, handed over guarantees of the fees tied. Quite shabby but it's theirs and it seems right. Quite happy ever after till the dreams bright. Jobs as teachers are married in the spring, waking up at dawn as their new life begins. Fulfilling their passions and interacting with lads in the lasses, compassionate practicing patterns of music for masses. Massively unfascist, friendly as can be. Did well at working and home life was neat. Except we'll get him erect and bed's weird. I guess she'd always felt the trouble and the fear. He appears well, but in the bedroom it nears hell. Asphyxiating, can't breathe till her neck swells. New from the start but it's got worse. Well, she ain't gonna tell anybody, it's like their hearts melt. Into each other for love she suffered, so we'll cover it up in the cupboard and bluff that she's tougher. Dreamed of kids, she wanted to be your mother, but she worried about his struggle with smothering undercovers, so. Thinking life's all dandy and fine, while he's upstairs wanking online. In the dark parts of the web he start feeling beaten, while beating his dick as he strangles himself screaming. Jobs got dropped cause they noticed he was different. Mannerisms changed and they never stay persistent. Although his body's there he's somewhere in the distance, but goes off when he's getting triggered like a piston. So he's home alone most of the time, staring at computer screens, sipping on some wine. Finds a part-time job working on the site of a yellow self-storage warehouse at night. Gets burning urges to take it to new heights. Absurd yearning, breaking his foresight. Dangers lurking, turns in the moonlight. Nature fades, he's deranged in a doomed fight. Texting his wife's friend, she's quite nice, it was clear she'd always liked him. Just the thought of this happening's what excites him. Cycles round through town, buzz the flat Brighton. Seems she got the idea after a slight hint. He enticed her quite politely when guiding this girl to her bedroom. Likes it when she bites him. What a beauty, hindsight is sufficing. Headboard crashed against the wall like a lead balloon. He starts to plant it in her flower as the sex bloomed. Started playing all her romantic best tunes. Gets wet, could rest, not knowing she'll be dead soon. He grabbed the missionary, entering her permissibly. Started getting rough and she struggled, starting her misery. Hands round her throat till she can't breathe physically. Fixed upon his climax, he carries on unwittingly. Till he's finished and he sees that the figure he's just fussed, not moving, rolled the epitome. To work a week after, denying any knowledge he's holding of her disaster. Going drinking in the evenings, getting plastered. Passing photographs to others on net faster than police could try to find her. Putting up the posters and the local news reminders. Time's running out, mysterious circumstances are certainly furthering chances of charges. And now the case is bringing a crowd. Precious on, gotta find where this girl's hidden about. Sitting at the desk and he hears a shout. Screaming, seeing colleagues chucking sick at the mouths. The body was found, laying among stock on the ground. With a smell so horrendous, it's rotten and brown. So every time I walk past the yellow cell storage in Brighton, I think about the story before this.
A salesman obsessed with violent pornography and strangulation has been convicted of the murder of a special needs teacher. A jury at the Old Bailey rejected Graham Coote's claim that Jane Longhurst died when a sex game went wrong. Coote will be sentenced in the morning. He was first found guilty of Miss Longhurst's murder in 2004, but the law lords courts ruled his conviction was unsafe on a legal technicality. The case has brought a change in the law. Measures prohibiting extreme and violent pornographic images on the internet are likely to be agreed in the next few months.